What would be a mind-body-spirit-Rx? What is a prescription that's going to take these three facets into account? Starting with the mind, I've got to tell you, there's nothing like cutting through the noise and really learning about our bodies and the world around us. What I mean is, what are the things that support health? I write books, a lot of others do, trying to share that information, and it's really good to try to cut through the confusion by educating yourself. When it comes to your body, some of us use our body a little bit like a garbage disposal. You know exactly what I'm talking about, where we're putting in things that really you would not want a loved one to eat, but we eat them ourselves. Okay, it's good to stop doing that. And the beauty of it is that if you've really eaten in a pretty healthful way for a week or 2 weeks, you kind of forget about the junk food. Where people run into trouble is they've been having contraband every single day, and then it becomes sort of addicting. So you want to get out of that rut and really treat your body right. And then when it comes to spirit, to me, what I'm really thinking about is the world that we live in. When I was a kid, I grew up in North Dakota. My extended family raised cattle. And at some point along the line, I realized those cattle were not volunteers. And when we think about our place in this world or with animals, at the risk of sounding like a person with a heart, and no doctor wants to be mistaken for such a person, Americans eat 1 million animals every hour. Let me say that again. Americans eat 1 million animals per hour, and the rest of the world is following suit. And if you look at what happens to them, it is just as bad as you thought. And when you look at what happens to the earth, by raising feed grain and feeding it to animals and then having the climate change issues that result from that, it's not your imagination, it's true. And when your 7-year-old daughter says, you know, I don't think I wanna eat animals, she's the smartest person at the dinner table. That is a future cardiologist. So when I think of what does it mean to have a good, caring spirit, it really means thinking of the world that we live in, taking care of it and the people that are in it. Nothing's perfect, but we're going to do the very best we can. And the payoff is going to be not just for us, and not just for the animals and the earth, but also your kids. They're going to love you. So that's my prescription.